Hi everyone, David here. Welcome back to the channel. Thanks for coming back for another video. Oh, welcome if it's your first one. Are you doing okay? I'm doing okay. I think last time I made a video, a few weeks ago, it didn't feel like spring was on the way. It was quite cold and rainy still, but like all of a sudden, spring came. It got very warm, all the cherry blossoms bloomed immediately. So that was a bit of a nice surprise. But it seems like it's almost over already. It's gonna rain today. I wonder if the cherry blossoms are gonna survive a few more days. Well, anyway, today I want to talk about some new exciting developments in the Osaka infrastructure. As you might know from my video previously, Osaka has quite a long, complicated travel network for trains. There's the Osaka Metro, which has got 9 lines, I think, all over Osaka. And between cities, we've got JR, we've got Keihan, Hankyu, Hanshin, all those kind of things. But today I'm going to focus on the metro adjacent network. I might have said before, but the Midosuji line is kind of the main north-south metro line, and that finishes officially in Esaka station, because then it kind of hands over the reins to another company called the Kita Osaka Kyuko, which is the North Osaka high-speed railway, I suppose, something like that. Which is part of the Hankyu Group. Hankyu Group is quite a large train company that includes the Hankyu lines, of course, Hanshin lines, and also the Kita Osaka Kyuko, or Kita Kyu for short. Recently they've extended their line. They used to only have five stations, Esaka and a few more, and then finish in Senichuo, which is where you can catch the monorail. But at the end of March they opened 2 new stations, so I thought I would go there, diligent journalist, and find out what's going on in those stations. I'll show you around. What does it look like? What does a modern, brand new metro station look like? And so that's what I'm going to do. So there we go. I'm going to hand over to myself. I'm going to do some narration, but please like this video. That would help me a lot, especially subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. I know the train videos seem to be quite popular, so I'll be making some of those in the future. Also leave a comment. Are there any other things you want me to check out on the infrastructure network, or how to do things on the network as well, like how to buy tickets I already made, but how about anything else? And of course, share the channel. If you have any train loving friends, please share this to them. That would help me a lot. I really want to get to 1,000 subscribers by the end of this year. I don't know if it's possible or not, but hopefully. Okay, so I'm gonna hand over to myself and I'll see you on the other side. Okay, here we are at Tennoji Station, under renovation at the moment, looking a bit run down. But the next train is heading all the way north to Mino Kayano Station, which is the new terminal station on the Kita Osaka Kyuko line. That does merge seamlessly at Esaka Station with the Midosuji line, so don't worry about changing trains. So here we are at the penultimate station, which is Mino Senba Handai Maya Station. The Handai part means Osaka University, that's their nickname. So here's the train information, updated route maps. There are QR codes for the schedules and other things, although there's not a lot of cell phone signal down here. So the station itself is quite stark and modern, not particularly exciting. It looks like an office supplies depot. So I decided to go up to the ground level. So this escalator is very deep. A lot of the modern stations are either above ground or they are deep underground to avoid the infrastructure. No people in the toilet, so I thought I'd take a little video there. I don't usually do that, but here we are, very nice and clean. We've got elevator access there too, and very space age looking, completely normal ticket gate. There's a little cafe off to the right, and you can see another staircase and escalator skipping the ground level all the way up to the second floor to see this performing arts center. There was some kind of event going on here, that's why there's so many ladies. I think there was some kind of idol performance happening, so very crowded, but a nice place to hang out and have some sandwiches. As you can see, a lot of buildings under construction still, so this is a very under development area. Now we've got the train station, so I wonder what this is going to look like in a few weeks, in a few years even. Now this is a nice suburban area, so there's a few small restaurants and a lot of affordable housing too. And a lot of cycle parking as well, presumably for the Osaka University students. But what I wasn't expecting is this high-tech entrance system, so you buy a ticket, a bit like a pay-and-display parking really. There wasn't a lot to see around there, actually, so I went back down into the depths. This is going back down to the basement first level. I decided to take the other route and go down this rather scary-looking liminal space tunnel and pop out the other side. Not much to see there apart from the highway and the mountains in the back, a bit of cherry blossoms there. Some rather strange architecture as well, some rather gothic arches on these. And stained glass window and rather 80s tiled looking buildings. Very interesting. I'm not really sure what this building's for. So there we go, that's Mino Senba Handai Maya Station. Very useful for the Osaka University students. There we go. I decided to carry on down, wait for my train to continue to the terminal. Like I said, you don't have to change trains. This track is shared with the Midosuji and the Kita Osaka Kyuko line. But this is technically the Namboku line on the Kitakyu. I wanted to show you the special trains for that company, but I got shortchanged. I got a Midosuji train here instead. Never mind. Very comfortable though, and they've recently refurbished their fleet. So here we are at the terminal station of Minokayano. And you can hear the nice chime as you can hear the train leaving. I'll let you see that. And we've got a new track information here. Minokayano on the left, all the way down to Nakamoza Station on the right. So there we go. Let's take a look. My train was leaving, so you can see out. This is an elevated station. You can see out to a nice park, some cherry blossoms down there too. As you see, not as crowded as Umeda, of course. And you can see Q's Mall in the back there, and Q's Mall on the left as well. So this place is fairly dominated by the Q's Mall at the end. And here we are, nice kind of wood panel-y looking modern station. Looks a bit like the monorail stations, to be honest. And I was going out the northern gate. So here we are at Minokayano Station. Nice modern looking sign as well. So most of this is dominated by the Q's Mall. You can see the advertising for the new open stations. So they're all open now. It's already happened. Q's Mall is quite a big mall chain. There's a big one in Tennoji, but this is quite a large one. There's three huge buildings, including Uniqlo, Food Court. There's an IMAX cinema as well. So the food court was pretty nice, absolutely crowded too. I decided to get an omurice with a hamburger on top of it, which was delicious. Even though my camera doesn't focus very well on near things. There's a Q's Mall building, that's near the train station. Looking around, you can see some nice cherry blossoms, a little stream as well. And panning around, you can see a Starbucks and another Q's Mall building. I think there are three buildings altogether for Q's Mall. It's pretty enormous. So there we go, shop till you drop, plenty of shop opportunities for you. And on the other side of the bridge, again, some more cherry blossoms, and you can see the station in the back there, along with a fairly nice kind of recreational park covered in astroturf. Probably be nice in the summer, I think. And you can also see Yuzuru-chan. I think he's the mascot for Mino City. Speaking of Mino, you can go to Mino Falls if you use this bus terminal, and some quite useful information. Take the Hankyu bus to Mino Falls. There's no train from there, unless you take the monorail from Senrichiro. Okay,
hi, thanks for coming back and staying all the way to the end of that video. I appreciate that. Was that exciting? I felt a little bit, I don't know what I was expecting from these new stations, but it felt a little bit basic. But these are suburban train stations, so it's not like we're going to USJ or anything. Like I said, I can't remember what I said now. One of the stations, the Handai Maya Station, is mostly built, I think, because it's so close to the Osaka University. So it's close to where a lot of students want to go. I don't know how they got there before, probably took the bus, or I don't think there are any kind of convenient train lines near there. So that's, nothing special there really. That's kind of a useful station more than anything, which is good. That's what infrastructure's for. The terminal station, that was... I've never seen a queue as more that big. I mean, there's one in Tennoji, but I don't think it's quite as big as that. I might keep that in mind if I want to go shopping after work and I can't be bothered to stay in Umeda. It's quite far away from my house though, so I don't know how useful that's going to be for me personally. But I hope that's very useful for the people living there. It's just kind of nice to see something new, really. The Kitakyu line is Bit of a mystery. A lot of people don't even realise it's not the Mizusuji line, so I thought I'd give it its moment in the sun. I told you I've been doing the Nazotoki games on the trains. They've released another one of those for the Kito Sakakiko line, which I am hopefully going to try in the next couple of months. So maybe I'll learn some more mysteries of the Kidoku. I might make a video once I get my head around to all the places you can go to there. So, well, I hope that was interesting. Maybe not as much as I had hoped, but here we are, we made it. So thanks for watching all the way to the end, and please like, subscribe, share this channel, that would help me so much, and leave a comment. What stations do you want to investigate next? That would help me a lot. So thank you very much, take care, and see you again. Bye bye.